we first started going out, we weren't really even girlfriend and boyfriend. It was really early days in our relationship. We decided to go away on a dirty weekend. Give us a cheer if you've ever been on a dirty weekend. It's a lot of you, but there will be more of you, but you will have just realised that it wasn't with the person you're sitting beside. Been on a dirty weekend. I didn't know what sorts of things you're supposed to take. Let's get some suggestions from you guys. Let's start at the top because that worked well last time. Anybody in the top level want to shout out what you think you take on a God, I haven't even finished the fucking sentence, love. There's a lady said handcuffs. What kind of handcuffs?
Furry.
There was last time I was working in Newcastle, a lady was on this level and she shouted out handcuffs like that. And I said, oh, have you got the heavy duty ones or the fluffy ones? And she said, I'm not telling you that. I'm sitting beside me, ma'am. You still shouted out fucking handcuffs. There was a fella the other day shouted out a bag of lube. And I was like, I'm pretty sure it comes in a tube. I imagined it being like an Asda bag for life. And he just dipped himself in every now and again. Anybody else upstairs want to shout? A rabbit. Oh, sorry. I thought for a minute I was like, moo. You mean, yeah, because I was in Cheltenham and three people shouted out rabbit one after the other and I thought, fucking hell, Chaz and Dave are in. Next level down, upper circle. Anybody got a suggestion what you take on a dirty weekend?
Anal beads.
Where are you? Where's... Hello, flower. Anal beads.
Wow.
Have you... Why am I whispering? I'm in the microphone. Nobody else is listening, Flower. Have you got anal beads?
I've got plenty of things.
Okay. I've got loads of things. I've got, you know, handbag and that.
Is that the most extreme thing you've got, love?
No.
Didn't think it was.
Now tell me about anal beads. They go up your arsehole, I figured that bit out myself. Can you still wear them as jewellery after that, though? Yes. Just make sure you've always got brown earrings and then you're fine.
Anybody else in the top two sections?
Willy warmers.
A willy warmer.
Why is it going to be so cold? I feel sad for the willy, do you?
I mean, there is some way you could keep it warm, love.
That's not an offer. Fuck, that sounded like a date. Why would you take a willy warmer, love?
A man's always cold.
Mine's always cold.
Have you tried just giving it a good roll? Let's come down the grand circle, anybody?
Cucumber!
A cucumber? Fuck you, I'm not taking salad.
Anybody else in this middle section?
Cake, where are you, love? Now you're fucking talking.
Now, is the cake for eating or like for... I don't know what that was. I was going to say smearing, but that feels like a really bad word. Smearing. Is the cake for smearing or for eating, love? Everything. Oh, a little bit of both. I like that. There was a lady the other day who said chocolate body paint, and I said, well, only if I can paint it on my palms and lick it off myself because I'm not fucking sharing. No, you stay where you are, love. It's definitely you making me do those noises. Oh. There was another lady shouting, shout again, love. Bread.
A friend.
Bread.
It was a couple of weeks ago, somebody shouted out creme fraiche, and I thought, ooh. And then when I got off stage, she sent me a message on Twitter saying, no, I said femme fraiche. Oh. Anybody else in that section?
Ball gag. A ball gag? That's something you haven't got, isn't it, love?
There was a lady, said, bondage gear. And I said, do you tie your partner up or does your partner tie you up? And she said, I tie him up and then I fuck off. Now let's do the rest of the boxes. And anybody downstairs got a suggestion what you take on a dirty weekend? What was that?
Hold on.
A what? A blow. Did you really say a blowtorch? In case you fancied a creme brulee. And was there another one over here? Where's the Viagra? Where did you? That you there? Oh, how you doing? You all right, love? Does that work for you?
That's how she was made.
Has she just found out as well, or? Oh, look at her, she's mortified. So is it, lovely girl, hello, is it good to know that your dad had a proper all weekend?
Two nights in a row.
What about the bit, like the daytime? Is it like that through the day as well? Or, you know, how do you get your clothes on? You just push it down and then just it like, boy, oi, oi, oi. I'm always disappointed they don't do that noise. Boy, oi, 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 oi.
Wow, 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 wow. It was Butlins. Viagra at Butlins. Sounds like a Mills and Boone, doesn't it?
The lady said crotchless pants, and I thought, well, I've often got a hole in, but it's never in the right place. But one thing you've forgotten as well is if you're going to take your rabbit, if you're going to take your you've got to take batteries, you've got to take spare batteries, because you don't want to turn into
wow, wow. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. All I'm doing now is stirring it.
I rang my fella before we went away and I said to him, I've been to family planning, and he must have thought, this isn't going to be sexy at all. I said, I've got some condoms because I'd heard they were free there and I love a bargain. And he said, well, that's good. I said, I've got 36, do you think that'll be enough? And quick as a flash, he just went,
well, you can leave 32 of them at home.
I thought, that's still four, though, isn't it?
And he went, we'll use two of those for water balloons.
It's good to know that he had activities planned, though.
Hi, I'm Sarah Millican, and thanks very much for watching my video. I'm on tour at the moment with a show called Bobby Dazzler. To find out where I'm going and when, go to sarahmillican.co.uk. Thanks. Bye.